فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. You guys are here today in the place where the Battle of Uhud took place. This is where Uhud took place. This was the second battle that took place between the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Quraysh, the people who he was from. The mountain behind me right now is the mountain which the Prophet commanded 50 men. It's called Jabal al-Rumat, which means the mountain of the arrows. He put 50 men here and he said, don't move from this place. Stay here. Even if you see birds coming from the sky and taking our flesh, don't move from this position. And so they stayed here. And when they saw the Sahabas moving and destroying Quraysh, what they did was they came down thinking that the battle was over and they wanted to take their spoils of war. So they came down. Whose command did they go against? The Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Because he clearly instructed those noble companions not to move from their position. And I want you guys to ponder and take a lesson from this. And the lesson is, when he told them to stay there, he only commanded them to stay there because of a revelation that came to him. Allah commanded him to tell them this. They came and they went to the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, and when they came to him, they lost the battle, because right behind here, from that corner, Khalid ibn al-Walid, who was behind the mountain, came and he destroyed them from the back. Khalid is later going to be a companion, but at that moment he wasn't a companion. So what the Prophet wanted was them to stay here, Khalid to come out, and then them to be behind Khalid and to destroy the army of Khalid. So they went against the Prophet's command. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, حتى إذا فشلتم وتنازعتم في الأمر وعصيتم من بعد ما أراكم تحبون منكم من يريد الدنيا ومنكم من يريد الآخرة ثم صرفكم عنهم ليبتليكم. Allah said, you lost the battle. My brothers and sisters, they lost that battle because they went against one command. Just one command. Not to come down this mountain. Who faced that consequences with them? The Messenger himself. What had happened was, when they came and Khalid, he sliced them from the back, a lot of them died. The Messenger, he lost his front teeth, it broke off, and he bled severely, alayhi salatu wasalam, that his helmet went into his cheek, alayhi salatu wasalam, and he bled severely. And this is a lesson that we take, number one. If we go against the command of Allah, Allah sends a destruction. Allah sends a punishment to those who disobey him. And who are going to suffer? Not the ones who, didn't do it will also suffer. And that is why we should all hold hands in staying away from the sins and following the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another thing that we learn from this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us in the battle of Badr, إِذْ تَسْتَغِيثُونَ رَبَّكُمْ فَاسْتَجَابَ لَكُمْ أَنِّي مُمِدُّكُمْ بِأَلْفٍ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. In the battle of Badr, which was the battle before this, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he lifted his hands up and he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what? He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for support and aid. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sent 1,000 angels. Those angels, they helped the companions. But I want you to ponder here with me. When those thousands of angels came down, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told the companions something. He said to them, وَمَا جَعَلَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بُشَرَى لَكُمْ وَلِتَطْمَئِنَّ بِهِ قُلُوبُكُمْ وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. These thousands of angels that are coming down, they are not coming down because they have victory in their hands. The angels don't have victory. And you guys don't have victory for this battle yourselves. Victory is in the hands of Allah. The angels, they only came down as glad tidings and to give you tranquility in your hearts. So we don't connect ourselves except to who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this battle, 70 of the companions were killed. 70 of them what? 70 of them were killed. From those who were killed is the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's uncle, Hamza. Hamza's buried over there. Hamza, he's buried there. And when Hamza was killed, he was killed by a man by the name of Wahshi, who later became a what? A companion. Wahshi's freedom was connected to killing Hamza. By the command of Hinda bint Utba, she said to him, go kill Hamza for me. Because Hamza had killed her father in the battle of what? Badr. Behind you is the great mountain of Uhud. This mountain, the Messenger said about it, Uhud loves us and we love Uhud. The Prophet climbed Uhud, the mountain of Uhud once, and it moved as he was on it, alayhi salatu wasalam, it moved. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he hit his leg on it, and he said, Uthbut ya Uhud. Uhud, stay still, don't move. Fa'innama alayka nabi. A Prophet is on top of you. Was Siddiq, Abu Bakr, the truthful one. Was Shahidan and two martyrs, Umar and Uthman. And this is one thing that we also need to take, is that when we come to these places, we need to remember they didn't come here and they didn't drive. They came here to defend the religion of Allah and to put their chest forward so the arrows can go to directly to them. So this religion can be high. We're here enjoying their efforts and their hard work. Don't play around with this religion. A people sweated for it, blood shed for it, efforts and hard work was put towards it. When you come to this place, you remember the noble companions that walked here with the Messenger, and they did not leave his corners. They stood shoulder to shoulder with him and they fought until they dropped. One companion came to the Messenger and he said, Ya Rasulallah, his name was Ukashat ibn Muhsin. He came to the Messenger, he said, Ya Rasulallah, my arrow broke. He doesn't have my sword, it broke. I need a sword, I need to fight. And the Messenger said to him, I don't have anything for you. And so the Prophet, he broke a branch and he gave Ukasha the branch. He said, fight with this. I ask you all, who would fight with a branch in a battlefield where people have swords? You would say, what are you doing to me? Do you want me to die? But he didn't say that because they trusted the Messenger and everything he said, they believed it wholeheartedly. He took it and he fought with it. That's the type of people the companions were. That's the type of people they were. So whoever insults the companions and puts the companions down, he's dim-witted. Something's wrong. Something doesn't add up. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the companions, according to the view which is strongest, the companions, they lost this battle. And the reason why they lost this battle was for them to remember not to go against Allah's command and to submit to that which Allah wants from them subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you're walking around here and you're looking around, look at it in a sign of pondering and contemplating and to try to take a lesson from it. That's all I wanted to say, inshallah ta'ala. That direction is Hamza, Mus'ab ibn Umair, they're buried over there. And other companions are there. Also, Quraysh, they came from that direction. This direction they came from, and the Sahabas, they came from that direction. They came from that direction and they met in the middle. And the fight, it took place for a very long time. You have to remember the sun, this is a very cold weather, you know. The period of time that you guys have come right now for Umrah, it is extremely cold. When they were fighting, it was hot, 50 degrees Celsius. Carrying swords that are so heavy. Walking through with all of this and knowing that they're going to meet death. All of that for whose sake? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sincerity that brought those companions out of their houses, let that sincerity be with you inshallah ta'ala. Through all that which you're doing and we're walking around, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem, subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.